Well, good evening and welcome to Elliott Astro Imaging episode 36. I am your host here tonight, and tonight we're going to do things a little different. A couple people have asked me in the last couple of weeks of how do you get good guiding? Like, how do you get that flat line? And tonight I'm going to explain a little bit how to do that. I haven't even done any polar alignment yet at this point right now. I'm just going to show everybody how I do it from start to taking the first image. So what I do is actually all I did right now at this point is roll out the mount and turn it on right now at this point. So right now I'm going to be heading outside for a little bit. So you're going to see what I'm doing on the actual screen, but you won't actually physically see me. So you're going to see how I set it up. Now I'll explain everything step by step and how I do it as I go along. So bear with me. This is a different process. It's not like what I've done in the past. Usually I'll start the episode right from guiding. So this is going to be different. I may make a couple of mistakes along the way, but at least you'll know how it works. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to pull up PhD guiding. Okay, with PhD guiding, I have 1, 2, and then I have 2 instances with PhD 2. And the way to do that is you would have to right click it, and then what you would do is you go to, I think it's new, and then you would just go to shortcut. And then what you'll do then is you'll be able to type in an instance to actually get this. And I'll put it in the description of how to do that exactly. So for a lot of people that are wondering, well, how do you get 2 cameras to work on PhD 2? Because if I were to click this PhD guiding 2 once and then click it again, it's going to say you can't do that. So like for me right now, I have this one here which is running outside, and then I can click this one here and I can run it a second time, which the first one again is the Logitech camera that's outside. It's Logitech 920 that is just on a standard tripod, and it's just pointing it at the mount. And then I also have this one, which is for the guiding, which is through the Mi DSi, and that's through the guide scope. And that would run 2 instances, and then I can run a third instance, which is the PhD 1. This is the original PhD guiding, not 2. So it's a little bit different. You can see that there's not many stats or anything on there, but I don't need that. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go to down below here. It's called WDM style web camera. We're going to double click it. The integrated camera is the webcam that we're looking at right now, right through here. That's through the laptop. The Logitech one is outside looking at the mount. And then the Microsoft LifeCam, that's what I want. We don't want to go too much, so we're going to just do, where is it? 720 to 1280 by 720, and we're just going to hit 1 second exposure. So this is what the Polar Cam is looking at right now. I have to go outside, and I have to do that. The one way I like to do things is I like to go to mypc.com. What this will do is it'll load onto my phone, and then I can actually screen share what I have on my phone. So I'm going to do that right now. So between now and actually doing the guiding process, I'm going to be outside. So you might not be able to hear me, but you will definitely see everything that I do. So I am heading outside right now, and then you'll be able to see how I get perfect polar alignment. I wouldn't say 100% perfect, but pretty close. I'll be back in a couple minutes. Okay. So, I'm going to explain a little bit on how this works. So, as you saw over the last 45 seconds to a minute and a half of doing the polar alignment here, is you saw for a glimpse for about a quarter of a second the circle, which was the actual polar scope itself. The camera is looking through it as a Microsoft LifeCam 1080p webcam, unmodified, and it is attached to the polar scope with Gorilla Tape. So from there, all I do is shine the light from my camera phone into it so I can see the circle of the polar scope. Then I would actually pull up the app on my phone to show where is Polaris according to the actual celestial pole. Once I know where that is, I just make the adjustment left or right to get it right on the actual circle. I have it upside down, so it is reversed, but it's actually the right way because it's upside down because the polar scope is flipped. I know that's confusing, but it works. So, it's on the right side. So, it is done. It is set and ready to go, so I can X this out. So, right now, the mount is polar aligned. Simple as that. I don't have to reach into the actual mount. I don't have to bend down and look underneath. Anything like that, it's right there. I can get it within a quarter of an arc second of how close I can get it to the actual circle. Now, is it 100% accurate? No. I can spend 10 minutes trying to get this 100% accurate, but this works for me. I can get 10 to 15 minute exposures without any problem at all because the guiding will help me through it. So we're done with this. So then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go through the Mead DSi. Now I have two Mead DSis. I have a color and I have a monochrome. The color is the guiding camera. The monochrome is what I use for the finder. So we're going to use the Pro. And then we're just going to take 3-second exposures. We're going to put the bullseye on, so this way I know where it is in the sky. And then we're just going to hit take exposure. So then this will take the exposure with it here. So this is ready to go. We're going to bring up the exposure just a little bit here so I can see exactly where everything is. And it is a pristine night. It is absolutely beautiful out there. I kind of underestimated the Medusa, so I don't know what I'm going to be getting tonight. We're going to find out. I'm going to figure something out on the fly. The building is a little bit higher than I thought. Medusa sits right between the star Procyon and then the twins of Pollux and Castor. It sits between halfway between them. They are at about 32 degrees in altitude, and it is setting. So even if I were to get out here at 8 o'clock right when it gets dark, it's still going to be pretty tough with the building being right there. I would need longer cords or just eliminate the building completely. And then I'd have all night. And then I have at least a couple hours. But unfortunately, there's not much I can do. So now I have the finder up. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to head back outside and I'm going to use my phone again to get the two-star alignment. A couple people over the last, I'd say, week or so have asked me, well, how do you do the two-star alignment and what works for you? There is no wrong way of doing it. The way that I do it, and of course people can criticize me, do what they want, but this is how I do it, is I would pick a star in the east, whether it would be Vega, Arcturus, Mizar, any star that is rising or close to it, and then pick a star within 20 degrees of it. I don't even worry about the west. Don't even care. I just don't care about the west. Only do the east. Pick those two stars and calibrate between the two of them. And then get it closer and closer and closer. And then you're done. And then just align it. And then you're done. You don't even have to worry about it. Once you get the two-star alignment done, and you don't touch the mount, and you get it exactly on that circle every single time, you just hit last alignment. You don't even need to do it. You just go with it because the go-to is not going to be that far off, especially with going with 80mm telescopes with the refractor. You don't really need to do much. If you're doing it with a 6-inch, 8-inch, Cassegrain, anything that's big, you're going to have some major drift, and you're going to have to do the two-star alignment every single time because you're magnifying this that part of the sky so much. So I'm going to go back out there. I still am doing the screen sharing as we speak with my phone, so I'm going to go back out there, and we're going to get this 100% ready to go. So just give me 1 second. Alright, so the star that I'm on right now is Arcturus. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to be pulling up EasyCap right now at this point to see where it is on my camera here. See how close it is, and then I'll make adjustments as I go along. We're going to do a little bit shorter than that. We'll do 4 seconds. Okay, and then we'll just make adjustments as I go along. And this way, you'll be able to see the star move and go from there. We're switching back to Arcturus as a calibration star. And as you can see, it is going right near the center of where it was before. So that is Arcturus. I did not need to move the mount. It went right to where it needs to be because it is a calibration star, and I'll be doing the same thing with my star in about 30 seconds. And we're moving, so that way now we're going to go right back to Mizar, so it should go right pretty close to where it was. And there it is, exactly where I want it, exactly where it was before, and it should stay right there. Mizar is the star on the right. It is a double star in the Big Dipper. And that's exactly where I want it. So we are calibrated and aligned. And we are set. And now we are polar aligned. So with the finder, it's off by just a little bit. I'm just doing this as a center. It has moved over the last 9 months. I have not moved it back to the center of here. But again, it's a broad basis, so this way I can tell and see where it is. It's pretty close, which is not bad. I mean, that's perfectly fine. So, not horrible. So, we're going to move this back over down here. So, this way that's out of the way. And that. Yes. So, now we are back. So, now we can pull up. All right. Get it to where we want it. Alright. Telescope control and connect. We did the two star alignment, so we should be good to go with that. You're aligned. There it is, exactly where I want it, exactly where I need it to be. Fantastic. So we are set to go with that. Now, where do we want to go tonight? Well, it's a tough call because there's really not much going on. I wanted to get the Medusa Nebula. It is, let me take a look. You have Capella there. I think this is the twins here. This is Castor and Pollux. And this is Procyon right here. It sits like right here. And it's setting. And it's setting fast. So the chances of getting this one with the building, because the building is like right here. Because I don't have a cord long enough that I can go all the way out. So that way I can go over the building. I just can't. I did not foresee that. I could try it, but I might not be able to get it, unfortunately. I may have to wait another time to get that. That right there, that's Jupiter right there. Let me move this out of the way. Bring this down. So this way I can see exactly what I want to get. Pinwheel is just too high up. It's running at 63 degrees altitude. So probably not that. Let me try. Star clusters, we're good with that. Try bright NGC objects, historical nebula, supernova, NGC. Okay. That's just too high up. Oh, let's see. Thanks.